Hi, my name is Jennifer Butterworth, and I'm the owner of My Bookkeeper. Today I'd like to show you how to correctly post credit card charges and payments in QuickBooks. Many people post credit card payments incorrectly in QuickBooks. They simply write a check in the Write Checks area, and what they do is they post to the expenses and they split out each transaction. This is not the correct way to post a credit card payment and to expense all the charges. So let me show you how to do this correctly. There are three different ways. You can enter receipts as you receive them and or as you spend, which allows you to keep track of spending and helps you stay on top of customers or clients that you may be tracking job costs, budget, proposal, or estimate for estimate purposes. Or when you receive your monthly credit card statement, you can post all the transactions then. Or you can also, some credit card companies do allow you through QuickBooks to set up online downloads. So you can automatically download monthly or however often you want, download all your transactions and online payments. You have to go online and set up a user, your user account through Discover or Visa, whichever bank you have your credit card through. If you set on an online existence, then what you'll do is you'll go into QuickBooks and you'll set it up for the online transactions. So anyways, let me go ahead and show you how to post your credit cards manually. First of all, you'll have to have your credit card set up. So you'll go to List, Chart of Accounts, and you'll see I already have credit cards set up in here. I have several credit cards in my sample company set up. This little lightning bolt shows that these are set up for the online downloads. Okay, this one here is not, so we're entering those manually. This is the one we're going to use today, but I want to show you real quickly how to set up a credit card account. So you're going to go to Account and New, and then you're going to select Credit Card, Continue, and then you'll enter the credit card name here, your credit card number, and whatever other information you want to fill out here, and then Save and New, or Save and Close. If you're going to enter more than one, you do Save and New. Okay. And then you'll see your new credit card here. Okay, to go ahead and start entering charges, what you're going to do is you're going to go to Banking, Enter Credit Card Charges, and it'll bring you to the Enter Credit Card Charge window. For today's example, we're going to use Cal Oil Card. And I'm going to enter my charges here. You just fill out the screen. You have a reference number, you enter that here, the charge amount, we're posting this to fuel or to whatever expense account you need to post it to. You can also enter a memo here if you have anything specific you want to post it to. I like to cut and paste and put it here in the memo section because this shows up on the reports. Also, if you're using items, you would post it on this tab here, and you would pull from your items list if it's posted to an item instead, and you'd fill out this screen. But we're posting it to an expense for fuel here. Okay, then you're going to save and close. That's how you post the charges. Now, if you double-click on this, you'll get your register. Okay, and if you enlarge that, you'll see all your past charges. And then you'll see here your payments. Okay. To post a payment, you'll go to Banking, Write Checks, and you'll pull it from whatever account that you're paying from. I'm using checking here, if you have operating, whichever account you're using. Okay. Now, if you're printing a check, you'll check it off to be printed. If you're handwriting a check, you'll put whatever check number that is. Okay, and you're going to fill this out, and we're going to pay $200 towards this. Oops. Put it on account. And then here is the important part. When you're paying a credit card payment, the account, you're going to type in the credit card account, which is going to deduct it from the liability account. So you're going to have less amount in the liability account here. Okay? And then you can do save and close. Then here you'll see in your register your $200 payment. Now, what I do recommend is that you reconcile your account each month to make sure that you capture all the client or customer costs. Also, so that you pick up any erroneous charges on your account or any fraud that might, you know, if somebody charged something against your account that is really not your charge. And to verify that you've entered everything correctly if you're entering it manually and that there's no duplicate entries or you forgot to enter something and that your account is actually balancing. If you have any questions on how to do the reconciliation, you can look at my past reconciliation video on bank reconciliations. You do it the same exact way. So I hope this video was helpful, and you can look forward to some of my other videos. Thank you for watching.